It's another year of high-tech scrutiny for spawning chum salmon in the Skagit River. Seattle City Light biologists working with the three Skagit River tribes and Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife are in the second year of a study that tracks chum salmon in the Skagit River. City Light fish biologist Dave Flug says the goal is to figure out how to best manage the river and the fishery it nurtures.
This is more or less the jewel of Puget Sound when it comes to salmon production. It has some of the largest runs of Chinook, some of the largest runs of chum salmon, pink salmon, coho, steelhead. All of them have fisheries on them, which is very unique in the Northwest.
That means plenty of fish for tribal treaty fishing, as well as commercial and sports fishermen. Managing the fisheries requires knowledge of how the fish species deal with changes to their natural habitat. That's where the study comes in. About 10 miles up the Skagit River from Puget Sound, the fish biologists are spreading a net to ensnare returning chum salmon. The netting part of the study is how the salmon are tagged. The fish that are caught get both traditional jaw tags and the new high-tech hydrosonic transmitters inserted into the stomach of the fish. In the past, the conventional tags told the scientists where the fish ended up after their death, but the high-tech acoustic tags give a more detailed record.
One of the goals, one of the objectives, was to determine what the distribution of chum are in the system. And the beauty of using those hydroacoustic tags is that we can follow them in sort of a passive way all the way through the watershed. And they will tell us where they're going to go because of the signals that they're sending out. And by determining what the distribution is, we can manage this resource a lot better.
This tagging goes on over a 10-week period during the annual fall return of the chum salmon. City Light has deployed special receivers along the river to track the salmon after leaving the spot. Each unique acoustic tag gives the scientists a much more detailed picture of when and where the salmon go on their way to spawn and then die. Since City Light manages a series of dams in the Upper Skagit watershed, it plays an important role in managing the habitat of the fish. When to release water and how much helps determine the survival of the eggs and the emerging young salmon. And the study is already providing important evidence.
The hydroacoustic study that we did in 2006 showed that 50% of the chum salmon that are coming back to the Skagit River are using the upper Skagit, the reach that's affected by our project. The other 50% are downstream in the main stem of the Skagit River, but very few of the fish went into the Sauk and some of the tributaries. So I guess from what we saw last year, it's clear that the flows that we're using to manage some chum spawning and to protect salmon in general is working.
Many more weeks are required as the biologists retrieve the information from the instruments and compile the results of this year's study. Connie McDougall, Seattle City Lights.